The estrogen, the second hormone produced by the placenta. One of the important things to know about this estrogen is that it cannot be synthesized all alone by the placenta, as it lacks the enzyme 17 alpha hydroxylase. Now, by your knowledge of biochemistry, you know that this progesterone is converted into 17 hydroxyprogesterone by this enzyme 17 alpha hydroxylase. So, and further in this cycle, the estrogens are produced, the estone and the estradiol. So, since our placenta lacks this hormone 17 alpha hydroxylase, so this entire cycle is interrupted, and so it cannot produce these estrogen by its own. So, from where does this estrogen come? We have the fetal adrenal glands, which produce DHEAS, that is dihydroepiandrosterone. Now, this is utilized by the placental enzymes to synthesize estradiol and estriol. So, our placenta depends upon the precursors from the fetal adrenal gland and from maternal sources for this DHEAS, which is further converted into estrogen. So, this entire concept of the mother, the fetus and the placenta acting together as a maternal fetoplacental unit to secrete this estrogen is called Dick Faluzzi's concept. Now, two important questions. What is the most common estrogen during pregnancy? If the question is most common, your answer is estradiol. It is the most common estrogen during pregnancy. But if you are asked the most specific estrogen during pregnancy, then your answer will be estriol. Here, one more concept that I would like to give you is that it is this estrogen which is required for uterine contractions at term in cases of anencephaly, since there is fetal adrenal glands hypoplasia or their absence. So, this DHEAS will not be produced, and in turn, the estradiol and estriol are not produced, and thus the initiation of uterine contractions at term will not occur, and it will lead to post-dated pregnancy in anencephaly. The oxytocin has to act on an estrogen-primed uterus, and so they are also refractory to oxytocin. In anencephaly pregnancy, if you are giving oxytocin, usually they do not respond to it. Now, this estrogen is first detectable at 9 weeks of gestation.